नमस्कार स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू योर योगा क्लास। व्हाट एन इवेंटफुल संडे वी हैड ऑन द ओकेजन ऑफ इंटरनेशनल योगा डे। वी रियली अप्रिशिएट ऑल द एफर्ट्स दैट यू हैव पुट इन व्हाइल क्रिएटिंग दीज वीडियोज विच यू हैव पोस्टेड, द इमेजेस विच यू हैव पोस्टेड, ऑल ऑफ दीज आसनास एंड प्राणायाम्स एंड मुद्रास व्हाट यू हैव पोस्टेड आर वंडरफुल टू सी and very encouraging for us that our students are putting so much effort to learn this form of art. Really helps us to put in more effort to bring in more knowledge to you and to develop each one of you to the highest of the level. We thank you for that. So all of you, for today's class we will go through few basics of yoga, theory about yoga and types of yoga that we have. So first of all of you sit straight, keep your back straight, okay? Either if you are sitting down or on a chair, keep your back straight, close your eyes, do deep breathing, deep inhalation, deep exhalation. Deep inhalation, deep exhalation. Now chant Omkara. Once again, take a deep breath. Let's begin our class with the morning prayer. Hands in Namaskar Mudra, back straight, sit correct, proper posture. योगेन चित्तस्य पदेन वाचा मलं शरीरस्य च वैद्यकेन योपाकरोतं प्रवरं मुनीनां पतांजलिं प्राञ्जलिरानतोऽस्मि आबाहु पुरुषाकारं शंखचक्रासिधारणं सहस्रशिरुषं श्वेतं प्रणमामिं पतांजलिं। ओम। Up your hands, place it on your neck. Okay. So let's begin our session. Students, in the previous video I had posted the morning prayer and the closing prayer for our yoga asanas. A few of the students have achieved 80% of it and still they have to practice it more. I think it has been almost 1 week now that I have posted the last video for prayers. And I wasn't satisfied by most of the students who have replied back with their prayers. Either their rhythm was not correct or else either their words were not correct. Some of them have used other prayers in your yogasanas. According to our syllabus and our curriculum, we will be learning the prayers which I have given to you in the video. It has been approved by our management and school, so you have to practice that. Only those prayers will be used during our starting and closing. Okay, so it is fine if you can learn other prayers, it is very good, but learn also these prayers as it will be our prayer, as a common prayer for the GPRMS students. Okay, so learn these prayers and kindly post back your videos, or just a voice recording is also fine. Okay, but do it in a proper rhythm. Practice well. I have seen that few students have posted right after half an hour. I have posted. So that is not the way to be done. You have to practice. Okay, practice those prayers and post it again. Okay, I'll do a proper correction and I'll let the children know who all where they were going wrong. Okay. And coming to yesterday's videos, which the asanas, I have seen that most of you have done very good asanas, Chakrasana, Yoga Mudrasana, and Mayurasana. Very good, I am so proud of you all. You should learn more and I want you all to excel in this art. Okay, so let's come back to today's session and the theory about today. Today we'll just go through about the two paragraphs about the yoga. The first paragraph will be about the foundation of yoga, from where yoga comes, from where yoga was developed, okay, and what yoga means. And the next is how many forms of yoga are there and types and styles of yoga. So I want you to either pause the video and write down this paragraph from here to from the word till the millennium, and then put the next heading as types and styles of yoga, and then again write down this paragraph. So I want you to write down these two paragraphs. Okay, I don't want you to pause this. I just want you to write it down. When we'll have a proper classroom session, I'll do my correction in your notebooks. Okay, right. So let's begin with the first paragraph. The word yoga comes from Sanskrit language. Like most of us know, Sanskrit language, the yoga is derived from the language of Sanskrit, which means union or merger. What is the meaning of union? Union means mixing of everything or joining of everything. Combining of everything is called as union. Okay, so union. Now what happens with yoga? The goal of this discipline is to strike a balance between body, mind, and breath. So these are the three things which unite together when you practice yoga: your body, your mind, and your breath. Now, as everyone know, what is our mind? Our mind is nothing but our brain. Now, the brain is everything. If the brain is functioning properly, your body is functioning properly. If your brain has some problem, okay, your body will not function. So you need to have a healthy mind, you need to have a happy mind, so that your body is also happy, you're happy, and you are making your society and your environment also happy. Okay, so yoga brings this balance in your life. It makes your mind healthy, it makes it happy, and it brings in a lot of positivity, lot of great energy, and indeed your body also becomes very healthy. The next is your breath. These days, as you know, this coronavirus, how it works is it goes through your nostrils. Okay, if someone has coughed or sneezed, and by mistake if you breathe in that, okay, what happens? It goes in through your nostrils, your mouth, or your eyes. It goes in, then it gets stuck in your throat, and then it slowly gets into your lungs. So what happens when it gets into your lungs? It blocks your breathing. This is what the coronavirus does. So to eliminate it, you need to have healthy lungs. Okay, these days people who are not having good healthy lungs are the people first being caught up with these coronaviruses. So you need to have a good immunity, you need to have good healthy lungs. For that you need to have good breathing. So when I say, when we meditate, we do deep inhalation, complete, your chest should expand completely. Then when you exhale, you should completely exhale. Okay, that will help to improve the capacity of oxygen in your lungs, right? and make your lungs very healthy. How much of oxygen you take in and how much you breathe out is what makes your body healthy. Okay. Then, with scholars that yoga is about, okay, with the ultimate aim of attaining self-enlightenment. What does that mean, self-enlightenment? Enlightenment word means happiness. Okay. How will you be happy? If your mind is happy, you don't have any tension, you don't have any stress. Even if you tomorrow, if you have your board exams also, if you are not having any tension, how you will not have tension? If you practice yoga, you will have positivity in your life. If, say, you are studying a chapter, it will help you to concentrate. Yoga makes a person concentrate in whatever he is doing, either it is physically or either it is theoretically. So whenever you are studying something, it captures in your brain, okay, that concentration level. They say it as a concentration level that improves only by yoga, right? So that is why the board, the CBSE board, also has implemented in your syllabus that all the children should learn yoga so that their concentration level is good, their immunity power is good, and they are having a healthy life, right? Next, it has been estimated by some scholars that yoga is about 5,000 years old, right? So what does that mean is actually in by the scriptures, if you follow, in Bhagavad Gita, it is written that Lord Shiva used to do yoga in Himalayas. Okay, he used to sit for meditation years and years in Himalayas. That was adapted by the great renowned Patanjali. Okay, one of the biggest sages, right? He is one of the biggest gurus, Patanjali Guru. He had adapted that yoga and simplified that form of yoga, and he gave it to the mankind as a gift, right? He simplified it in such a way that we can do it, or we can perform all these yogasanas and pranayams, okay, from the medieval times. Then several scientists also claim that this is a highly developed and scientific discipline for healthy living that has been perfected through millenniums. In simple words, when you breathe well, there is a lot of oxygen going in your body, your blood circulation is good, your organs, your body organs are receiving enough oxygen, enough blood flow is there. When you're doing your asanas, the blood flow is going to all your muscles, all your nerves, all your organs in the body. For example, if you are doing a normal Pavana Muktasana, your stomach is being compressed and then retracted. When it happens, okay, all the blood flow, all the oxygen in your organs are supplied, okay. And when you are doing your breathing in the asana position, what happens? The oxygen level goes into the organs and helps it to be healthy. Okay? So science also has agreed that it is very helpful, right? Next paragraph, which is types and styles of yoga. Now, since this is a 5,000 years old and it was introduced to mankind by sage Patanjali, then later on several gurus, they also learned this form and then they developed according to their own asanas. They followed by seeing a dog pose. They used to see animals, what they are doing, and then they adapted it into the scriptures of yogasanas. Then they saw how a cat breathes, and then there is a cat breathing also posture in yogasana. So there is so many adaptations. They saw tree. Now when we do Vrikshasana, how is that? It was adapted by a tree. The guru saw a tree, how it is standing, and then they developed and learned from that. Okay, so that is called a tree posture. Then we have mountain posture. Okay, then we have Adho Mukha Savanasana. What does that mean? Downward looking dog. So all these postures were adapted from animals, plants, trees, and all the objects in the surroundings. Okay, then we have Halasana. Halasana means a plow. All these things were adapted by seeing the environment and seeing the objects around, and then later so many types of asanas and yoga were developed. So first being Ashtanga Yoga and Hatha Yoga. This is what we are practicing. Ashtanga Yoga and Hatha Yoga is what we will be practicing during our syllabus. Then we have Kundalini Yoga, then Raja Yoga, Karma Yoga, Bhakti Yoga, Jana Yoga, Tantra Yoga, Mantra Yoga. And each of these forms have a specific purpose. Okay. So just remember that Ashtanga Yoga and Hatha Yoga is our syllabus. Okay, what we will be learning, in which we will be having asanas, pranayams, mudras, kriyas. Okay, this is what we will be learning. Coming to Kundalini Yoga, Raja Yoga and other yogas, it is more of an advanced level yogas, and they are more into meditation, more into prayers, more into serving Almighty God, more into serving your Guru, which is called as Raja Yoga. Then there is Karma Yoga. Karma Yoga is more about doing good to the society so that good happens to you. Bhakti Yoga is all about praise and worship to the Lord. Okay, praise, worship and dance to the Lord is called as Bhakti Yoga. Tantra Yoga, Mantra Yoga, all of these are various forms of yogas. Okay, so children, I want you all to write down these two paragraphs in your notebooks, right? And do a little bit of Google about it. Google about each one of these yogas. What are these forms of yogas? So that we are prepared for our next class. And so that it will be easier for me to explain you through this online session. And it in a good way, if you are doing your own research from your end, you will also be having that eagerness to learn this subject more. Okay. So altogether, we will close this session with the final prayer. Okay. Sarve bhavantu sukhinaha, sarve santu niramaya, sarve bhadra nipashyantu, ma kaschit dukkha bhag bhavet. Om shanti shanti shanti. Namaskar students, have a wonderful day ahead, and looking forward for your prayers which you have to submit it in the coming week, and I'll look forward and I'll give you the scoring according to how good your prayers were. Okay, thank you. Namaskar.